Pneumonia is an infection of the lung. First, we will look at the cause and the symptoms of pneumonia. Pneumonia is commonly caused by bacteria. The most common bacteria that can cause pneumonia is the Streptococcus pneumoniae, commonly known as a pneumococcus, and the Haemophilus influenzae type B, which is commonly known as the HIB. Please do not confuse Haemophilus influenzae with flu. Even though it has flu in it, this is a bacteria, not a virus like flu. Other causes of pneumonia can be viral. Common viruses that can cause pneumonia are the influenza, the flu, or respiratory syncytial virus, which is commonly seen in children. Fungus can cause pneumonia as well. For example, in HIV patients, PCP pneumonia is seen when their immune system fails. Pneumonia is the leading cause of death in children less than 5 years of age in the world. Mainly, there are two types of pneumonia: community acquired and hospital acquired. We divide pneumonia into these two categories because of the treatment options. Hospital-acquired pneumonia needs more attention and more aggressive treatment. Let's look at the symptoms of pneumonia. Since it's an infection, patient can present with fever and they can have shaking chills. Some patients can have chest pain with breathing because of the irritation of the nerves in the lungs. And a common symptom is cough. If you have these symptoms, it is critical that you seek medical attention as soon as possible from your healthcare provider. Now let's see what tests we can do and what are the treatment options. Your doctor can order a chest X-ray. This is a radiological imaging in which it looks for any consolidations in the lung and it helps to identify any infection within the lung parenchyma. Your doctor can order blood tests looking at the white blood cells and also to find the infection in the blood. Mucus can also be tested. Treatment for pneumonia involves getting plenty of rest while drinking plenty of fluids. Patients are given antibiotics, and these antibiotics can be taken at home by mouth or in the hospital. Some patients may even require the ICU, and your doctor will decide the best course of action. Usually in about 3 to 5 days, you should start feeling better. But if not feeling better by 3 days, you must immediately inform the healthcare provider because they might have to change your treatment plan. Finally, let's look at what we can do to prevent pneumonia. Wash hands with soap and water or alcohol-based rub. Clean surfaces because sometimes bacteria or viruses can remain on surfaces for prolonged periods. Quit smoking. Smoking can damage the respiratory tract, so the lungs can be vulnerable to infection. Good diet and doing regular exercises is highly important too. Vaccines can help to protect against pneumonia. Vaccines which can help fight against pneumonia are the HIB vaccine, flu vaccine, pneumococcal vaccine, pertussis vaccine, also known as the whooping cough vaccine, and measles and chickenpox. These vaccines are generally safe, but sometimes patients can have side effects. Now let's summarize pneumonia. It is the leading cause of death among children worldwide, and most commonly it's caused by bacteria or viruses. If you develop any symptoms, it is critical to inform your healthcare provider to determine your treatments, which most likely would involve antibiotics. And if you're not feeling well by the third day, you must again inform the healthcare provider because they might have to change the treatment plan. And we can prevent pneumonia by several methods, including vaccines. And that is a brief discussion on pneumonia. Thank you.